Hello there, girls and boys. Today, I'm going to be singing this track for you, Danger Zone by Kenny Loggins. Hello there, girls and boys. I hope you like my version of Danger Zone by Kenny Loggins. And now I will explain to you some of the tricks and some of the stuff that I learned out by listening to the track. One of the things that I like before we continue about this song is how cheesy yet effective and quite 80s the whole sound of the track is. It's quite an interesting sounding track, and you might make the argument that this is a little bit too dated for your liking, and I totally agree with you, but still, it sounds cool, and the guitar solo is fantastic, and Kenny Loggins' performance is awesome as well. There are many tricks that I would like to share with you, so let's begin. You'll see, girls and boys, the first section that I want to tackle is the very beginning, the very first verse, because there is something quite funny that Kenny does with his voice, which at the beginning of me trying to come up with this version, my cover, I wasn't expecting it to be this way. Let me explain. When you're singing, you get something that is called the dynamic range. And that's how we as singers can invoke emotion through the use of our voice, okay? And that means that we can use certain intensity levels to create a certain emotion, right? So in here, the song begins with something quite attacking, yet super breathy at the end of each phrase. So let me sing it for you, so you can have an idea, and then I will explain to you exactly what happened. And as any professional singer might know, the best thing to do while singing is reading your lyrics. So let's do it that way, girls and boys.
up your end, listen to her howling roar. Metal under tension, begging you to touch and go.
As you can see, girls and boys, when I hit the final phrase, begging you to touch and go, begging you to touch and go, you can see that I begin my phrase by attacking it quite harder, begging, even applying a little bit of vocal compression and making my sound a little bit more aggressive. And then I finish with touch and go, a lot of air, so I can make my vocal performance much more interesting rather than your quintessential super hard hitting rock and roll vocals. And at the beginning, I thought the entirety of this section was sang just by using that technique, like super breathy, touch and go, the entirety of the time. And what I discovered was that the track wasn't working correctly, because there is a little bit of aggressiveness in the beginning. So that was the first thing that I noticed. Secondly, it's important to keep track of the air, because this song is extremely demanding when it comes to air consumption. Because you might be thinking that this song is kinda easy to sing. Yeah, but it's easier said than done. Let me show you this next part, because in this one I actually struggle quite a lot, not only with keeping my breath, but also by getting the tempo correctly. So let's hit it.
You'll never say hello to you until you get it on the red light overload. You'll never know what you can do until you get it off the sky.
That's really, really tricky, girls and boys, because as you can see, I ran out of air as soon as I finished my singing. Why did that happen? That happens because this section is full of content, and the phrasing is extremely fast-paced. So it's really, really important to keep a really, really good strategy behind the way that you breathe and keep the air consumption following a proper tempo and rhythm. What did I do? Well, I breathe in quite a lot before starting singing. And also, every time that I sang something, I kept control on the amount of air that I consume per phrase and per word. Yes, that's something that we tend to do as singers. And also, I knew that I had to hit a really high note at the end, so I knew that I have to be even more conscious on the amount of energy I used on every single phrase. Especially here, as high as you can go. And also another trick. It's really important, and this is testament on Kenny Loggins' performance and actual talent, because the transition from chest voice, which is the voice that I'm using, to head voice, which is this, it's quite natural and quite easy. It flows naturally. So really, really well done. And now, of course, the super important chorus, which is basically the entirety of a song, I want to cover it at the end. Why? Because, to be quite frank with you, the chorus is kind of extremely repetitive, if I put it in a way. But this section has an interesting take. Let's play it out. Look, I missed the mark on the lyrics, but here is why, girls and boys. Kenny came up with a really, really cool idea or cool strategy on how to sing the sections. Because as you might know, this song, it keeps saying this the phrase highway to the danger zone quite often, basically every two bars during the chorus. And highway by itself, by its nature, requires a lot of air, especially when you say high, okay? So when singing, you can hear that Kenny is actually saying hi instead of hi, okay? And that makes a gigantic difference, because he is able to keep his air inside of his chest while singing and allowing him to sing the entirety of the final chorus, which is almost a minute. And also that final section, their sound! Really, really cool. And again, testament to how well he controlled his voice and the way that he controlled the transition from chest voice to head voice. So girls and boys, that was my interpretation and everything that I learned out of this song. Dangerous Zone by Kenny Loggins. Hey, thank you for watching. If you like this kind of content, the best way to support this channel is by listening to our music on Apple Music or Spotify, and also by following us on social media, such as Instagram, because that's the best way for you to get in touch with us in a much more personal basis. With that being said, girls and boys, I gotta remind you something. Never, ever, ever let anybody tell you what to dream about. And remember that I'll see you when I see you.